Hello guys and girls, and welcome back to yet another episode of Football Manager Reddit Edition. Today's episode we are going to dive straight into a game. Into the first match, we are going against Accrington Stanley. There are some interesting matches as well. Coventry against Luton. That's going to be interesting to watch. And they are in the promotion spot. They are fighting for that one. And also in the FA Cup, there are some matches as well. Manchester United already managed to win. Interesting career choice for Sturridge. He chose to play for West Bromwich. That's interesting. Did that happen in real life? Because I don't remember, but I don't think it happened that way. We managed to draw in the first half against Accrington Stanley, so that's interesting. I thought we have won against them, but obviously I was wrong. Let's make the quick selection now. Well, it can be quick for you if you skip ahead a few seconds, maybe a minute or two. But usually I don't like to skip this part. I don't want to cut it because I always commentate about my selection, why I choose. So if you guys don't like that, you can skip ahead. Otherwise, I'm happy that you follow the whole video, whole episode. So yeah, back to the team selection. I will bring McLean on the bench because I think he deserves some matches as well. Dima Grigoriev haven't played that many matches lately, so obviously he needs to play as well. I'll bring myself on the starting 11. Who else? I think we are good for now, guys. Or maybe, I don't know. I'm not sure if I should keep Sammy. I will go for Most Amazing instead, and I think now we can start the game. I want us to win this one. We really can't afford losing anymore. I said that our objective is to promote, not to win the title. I've changed my mind. Our objective now is to win the title. I've started to think about it, and I've came to the conclusion that it will be harder for us to win titles in the future. So if we advance, if we promote to League One and then to Championship, I still expect us to promote, but winning the title is going to be a lot harder. And then in the Premier League, it's going to be let's not say impossible, but very, very hard for us. And yes, it's going to be hard for us because, as you can see, we are struggling in the fourth division of English football, and we shouldn't really struggle. I know it's just a rough patch, but still, it shouldn't be as long as this one. I still hope that we can manage to win this game. It's still an early one, and they only had one shot on target, and unfortunately for us, that was a goal. But yeah, guys, we still have possession. We started to make some attempts as well, one shot on target. So maybe we can come back into this before the first half ends. And that will be awesome. And yeah, I decided to go for the title. I want to win the title in the third league as well, in the third division, SkyBet League One. And then in the championship, I want to promote. I don't care how, I just want to promote. As soon as we are in Premier League, the sooner the better. And we can focus on the cup matches, we can focus on European football if we get there. And now we have a good chance there from my assist, and Fidi managed to put it in. Very nice stuff. So exactly what I wanted, to equalize before the second half starts. So very nice. Let's see that again. So Grigoriev here with a very nice pass to me, and then myself with the assist for Fidi, who comfortably took the chance. So very nice so far, and we are starting to dominate the game. That's what I want to see. We have a lot of possession, and not many, but more shots on target. Actually, they had only one, the one in which they scored as well. And yeah, I don't think that justifies the score. I still think we need to win. Reddit City are still looking for the goal. So basically now they are our equals. Both teams are looking for the winning goal, and we'll see if we can manage to do that. And let's push forward a little bit, guys. Come on, we can win this. Okay, maybe it's time for the first substitution. But I don't know who to bring on. Bennett isn't having the best of games, but I'll give him more time to play. Still a little bit too early for substitutions. We are not struggling with match fitness, and we don't have yellow cards either, so there is no reason to make the substitution now, really. Let's see, now we have a highlight, or they have a highlight. Okay, good defending there, but they still have the possession. Not a fan of that, and they keep passing the ball around. That's not good. And now they are through, and they managed to score. Not what I wanted. Let's show some patience, please. Still half an hour left to play. More than that, actually. So I think we can win this. We can still win this. I had to take Bennett off, though. He wasn't playing well, and I think he had enough time to prove himself. But that's okay. McLean maybe can do it for us. Pavličević now coming on for Fidi. Usually Fidi and Pavličević are very similar players. I think they are both of the same caliber of quality. And Wombo is also very good, maybe even better, but I prefer to have him on the bench usually, because he's such a powerful and fast winger that when you bring him on, the difference is easy to spot. He makes the difference with the fresh stamina and the pace. So yeah, this isn't good at all. Christopher Allen is injured and he can't carry on the game. And we've already used all our substitutions, so we can bring Johnny Pizza on to replace him. And now that really puts us in a very difficult spot, guys. And I don't know if we are even able to equalize. Really, really unlucky match for us, I must say. We've started wrong, on the wrong foot, and after that we've kinda recovered when we equalized, but now it's all gone. We can't win this anymore. We can't even equalize, and we'll have to take another defeat, guys. I'm sorry for that. I've won the player of the match award, but I don't know why I've won it. I don't think I deserve it, but yeah, neither of us deserve this. None of the players deserve any kind of award for this match. And yeah, a bad start for this episode. And Reddit City didn't manage to win either, so that makes us feel a little bit better, but still, it's not very good for them. After a bad result comes a bad injury, guys. Christopher Allen is going to be out for 1 month, and I'll praise myself for winning the Player of the Match award, even though I don't deserve it. And it seems my response says the same thing as well. Stoke City have been eliminated from the FA Cup, guys. So let's say I'm happy about that. And finally, the second and last match of the episode is the only match played today in the in-game time. We are going to play home against Notts County, the team which has a very good form currently. They are sitting on fifth place and they are pushing for promotion. And they did manage to beat us in the first half of the season as well. So I don't think this is going to be an easy match, but I really want us to win this one. I know that I said the same thing about the previous one, but now we are playing at home, and we owe the win to the fans. We have to win this. So quick team selection. I will check for the match fitness of everyone. So there are a few players I would like to change, but let's see what we have on the reserve team as well. Players who haven't played for some matches. I think I'm undecided, but I think we are going to play Aaron as an attacking midfielder. Or actually, guys, let's bring on Helder Makengo, because after his nest injury he didn't play that much, and he needs to regain his shape, match fitness, and morale as well. So I think Aaron will understand my decision. And here we go, guys. Good luck. Let's hope we can put up a good performance this time, because we are sleeping off, and that's not good. I don't think we are in danger of losing the promotion, but I am still fighting for the title. I'm not giving up on it. So we have to start winning again. And the first highlight, they had a good chance a couple of minutes ago, and it could have ended up poorly for us, but we were lucky not to concede. And let's see, maybe we should get a little bit creative with our chances. We don't have that many, and we don't even manage to aim them on target, the shots we have. So come on, lads. We do have a good amount of possession though, so that's good. I'm looking at the match fitness as well. We are doing better than them, but not by a whole lot. They are pretty balanced. And yeah, not even a single shot on target in the first half. That's really poor from us. Noah Green managed to get a yellow card as well, the first yellow card of the match, and hopefully the last for us. 3 minutes of added time in the first half. That's quite a lot, actually. I'm not used to seeing so many minutes given in extra time in the first half. So yeah, guys, starting the second half now and hoping for a much better performance, and at least 3 or 4 shots on target, because I can't accept this. This is really poor. So I think maybe it's time to make our first substitution. So I don't know. I think I'll bring on Sammy for Green, because he has the yellow card, and I don't want us to risk this. If we can make the substitute, we are going to make it. And I did so. Let's continue to push. Come on, lads. Half an hour left. Now they have a chance. Or maybe not. We back pass it to our keeper, Ethan Williams, and now Brent Petpik at the ball. Let's see what he can do. A pass to myself, and then I give it back to Most Amazing. Most Amazing again. Sammy. Makengo back to Amazing. Some really nice passing there. Now our captain to Sammy. Sammy to Fidi, and now we have a chance. Fidi with the crossing to Bennett. And we finally score, guys. A very nice play there. First shot on target as well, I think. So let's see that again. Lovely pass here from Sam Lucera to Fidi, and Fidi well served Dan Bennett. It was a well served assist. So let's see, maybe now we can make the second substitute. Let's bring on Jason Grace for myself. I didn't had the best performance. I didn't do much. So I'll take myself off. 20 minutes left of playtime plus extra minutes, additional minutes. So we are close to getting the 3 points, but we can't relax yet. We still have about 20 minutes left. And let's be honest, we haven't played that well. Bennett is coming off. McLean is coming on. Let's see, we have a highlight now. A nice passing game again, fast and precise. That's how we want to play. And now Grace to Makengo again. Same type of play as in the first goal of the match. And I'm very pleased with that. It works for us, so why not? We take advantage of our wingers' speed and crossing ability. And Makengo with the tap in, very nice indeed. So this is much better now. We are leading by 2 goals, and I think it's safe to say now that we are going to get the 3 points. Let's see now. Again, we have a good recover there, a good recovery. Makengo back to Lucy to Lissera. Okay, that was a bad pass attempt from McLean. And now they have the ball. They are attacking now. Okay, they have a chance here. And Ayton Williams with the save. Good save. Let's praise you guys. Okay, let's defend this. Very, very nice. They are still attacking though. So okay, very good, very good. Let's waste a little bit of time and wait for the final whistle, guys. It's a good win, especially since we are not going to concede. And Jack West, I think he will get the man of the match award. And that's it, guys. Not the best performance, but I'll take this. It was a clean sheet and a win, so that's all we need. And yeah, guys, we are still top of the league, but we are separated only by goal difference. Coventry has the exact same number of points, 69 for that matter, and we'll see what the next episode will bring us. And speaking of the next episode, let's check out the next fixtures. So we are going to play against Colchester away and Port Vale at home. So yeah, look at this rough patch we've been through. We've almost lost 5 matches out of 5, but hopefully we will recover soon, and we'll see that in the next episode, guys. Till then, take care and bye.